हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू द लेक्चर ऑफ मार्केटिंग मैनेजमेंट MM. बिफोर दिस लेक्चर और इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी टॉक्ट अबाउट पैकेजिंग. आई हैव टोल्ड यू इन दैट लेक्चर दैट इन दिस सीरीज वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट पैकेजिंग, लेबलिंग, वारंटी एंड गारंटी एटसेट्रा. सो दिस लेबलिंग टॉपिक इज एक्चुअली द पार्ट ऑफ पैकेजिंग. सो हाउ वी आर डिफाइनिंग इट, वट आर द फंक्शंस ऑफ लेबल, वट एक्टिविटीज लेबल perform for a product, all these things we will discuss today in today lecture. Now going to the definitions of label. So topic is labeling. What is the definition of label? Label can be a simple attached tag or elaborately designed graphic that is part of the package. It might carry a great deal of information or only the brand name. Once again, I'm going to repeat it for you people so that you can understand the concept of packaging. Labeling. Label can be simple attached tag or an elaborately designed graphic that is part of the package. It might carry a great deal of information or only the brand name. We talked about, actually before going to the explanation of this definition, you should remember one thing, that packaging is the covering that or the container of the product. Whatever is written over there on the package, or what color combination or logo or what design is made on the package, that is called label. Label of the package. So label can be a simple attached tag. There is a tag on the package, that is also a label. Or an elaborately designed graphic that is part of the package, or there may be a design, there may be a picture, there may be a logo, or it might carry a great deal of information. Certain times there is a large number of information given on the package, that is also a label, or only the brand name, or simply brand name is written over there, that is also a label, or logo is there, that is also a label, or a great deal of information is there, or some tag is there. So all these things, what the designs, the color combination, the logo, the name, other informations, combinedly we are calling them label. Or if anyone, the names which I have taken over here right now, any one of them which is present on the package, that is called label. So now why we are giving so much importance to the label? Functions of label. Number one, product identification. Number second, describe the product. Number third, promote the product. It performs many more functions, but we have discussed only three of them. That number one of them is product identification. Obviously, it identifies the product by having the logo, brand name, information, expiry date, price tag, all these things we are calling them label. So it helps the consumer to identify the product. If there is no label on the package, so obviously it will be very much difficult for the consumer to identify the product. So it is the major or main role of label to make the product identified by the consumer. It is called product identification. Number second, it describes the product. It gives information about the product. Contents, what material are used in the manufacturing of this product. I told you, expiry date, manufacturing date, expiry date, price of the product, contents of the product. So that's why we say that it describes the product. At the same time, it promotes the product. Promote the product means that these labels all are in such attractive look that it attracts the customers to purchase the product again and again. So it also works for us is print media. In print media, I have told you in previous classes that in print media, what we are doing, we are writing some information about the product. So that's why we can say that label promote the product for having attractive color combination, logo, information, etc. So it is promoting the product in the society and attracting the customers towards itself. So now probably the picture of label is clear to you. What is labeling? Labeling means giving label. What is label? Any color, logo, name, information on the package is called label. Label may be very short, simple brand name or simple logo of the product or color combination design, etc. Or we can say that it might carry a large number of information contents of the product: fat, quantity, carbohydrates, nutrition, all these things are given over there. It may carry a large number of information, or it may be simply a tag, or it may be simply a logo, or simply a brand name. That is called label. And process, and this process of attaching these things to the package is called labeling. Now, from where this labeling or label came out, popped out, there is a history of labeling from law point of view. As Nigahi Kanun, the Kanun Nazarnaham, so you structure lari, you tarikh lari, so we are calling it history of the labeling. In 1914, FTCA held that false, misleading and deceptive labeling means unfair competition. This is the name of an act, a law regarding labeling. They are saying that if you have written some wrong information on the label, it means that there is unfair competition. Unfair competition is a crime. It is not allowed. It is unethical behavior. So this is one law passed in America in 1914, and the name of that law is FTCA. So that law was held, that law was passed in 1914. They say that if your label carries any misleading information or deceptive information, it means that you are involved in unfair competition, and that is not allowed by this act or this law. Then in 1967, Fair Packaging and Labeling Act. This is the name of another act. Act means a portion of law regarding a specific thing. It is called act. So that act is about Fair Packaging and Labeling Act. Means that this act, this small law, is giving you instruction about fair packaging and labeling. How to have fair packaging and labeling. The name of this act, abbreviation, is FPLA. So this law was passed by Congress, in which they have given a large information, they have given instructions which type of labels you should have. It should not be misleading, it should not be deceptive. What things should be included over there and what things should not be included over there. This law explains all these things about general labeling. Then FDA, Food and Drug Administration, it is governmental agency in America about the food materials. They are controlling the food materials in the market, food and drugs or food and medicine. So what they say, they have told us that it is required processed food producers to include nutritional products information. To include nutritional products information. So this law was passed by FDA, Food and Drug Administration, which says that on all products which can be consumed or which can be taken or which can be drank, all informations regarding the nutritions must be involved over there. Like what is the quantity of fats, carbohydrates, proteins, etc. should be clearly mentioned over there, but that should be laboratory tested, not false statements. So this is also a part of labeling or labels nowadays. So this was our topic about labeling. You should search about it. You should learn more and more about labeling. But however, at this point, I will tell you that all the things written or mentioned or designs or logo names which is present on the package, which helps the people to identify the product, describe the product and attract the customers, that is called label. This was our today topic. Be with me for coming classes. Stay at your homes, just focus on your study and be safe. Khuda Hafiz.